on the agenda is members' court of conduct, declaration of interest. Anybody got any declarations for this meeting? You already have. Declaration? No? apologies for absence. I've had two sent to me from Stuart Kelly and Julie McManus. Okay. Stuart, you accept that? Minute to the meeting, the last meeting, changes 1 to 6. Fifth vote for someone who knows the true record. Thank you. And are there any matters arising from those minutes? Do you want to bring up that is on the agenda tonight? Okay. Then we move straight into our first presentation tonight. I'm asking one of you.
To move towards a shift of positive communities, people back in, re-engage within their local community. We want to develop new friendships. One of the ideas that we have is about utilising skills. So if we knock on somebody's door and they are isolated but they have an asset in them, which is something, it could be anything, but we'll use fishing, we would love to set and support them with a fishing group to connect them with other people within the neighbourhoods that have the same interests. Reduce their isolation of being at home and get them out and again out of our school. And the overall aim of the project is to improve people's well-being.
So who benefits? The more people are connected in the neighbourhood, the better the health of everybody gains. Cllr looks to reach out to people who may feel they are in a grey area. They are working age and have found themselves in receipt of ESA, IB or sometime. There could be UC with a sick note as well, so universal credit, because obviously the rollout is going to take place. The areas that we cover are Birkenhead, Prenton, Oxton, Leeso, Morton, Sorbal Massey, Overchurch, Woodchurch, St James's, Claughton, Bidston Village, Beechwood, Easton, Bromborough, Tramier, Rock Ferry, Wallasey, Liscard, Seacombe and New Brighton. Working alongside partnerships, Cllr has to work alongside projects, services and community activities across Wirral as community means everyone. Connect Us is already ensuring we are establishing ourselves out there, building on connections, ensuring information is being shared and referral pathways are strong. Connect Us can serve as the missing link for some people to access the things they need in order for them to move forward and endeavour to achieve their aspirations. So currently, we've been out and got in touch with all the leaders in each area, local councillors, community groups. So just to give you an idea, DWP, Age UK, Wirral Ways to Recovery, Health Junction, NeoCAF, Tramie Rovers, Wirral Connect, Places of Welcome, Leeso Community Homes and Salvation Army, amongst others. And we're also knocking on doors.
Corrections.
Just a quick one, if you don't mind. I see we've got the both trends and opposites. Does that include Rock Ferry, Bidston?
And Bidston Village. Yeah. And Beechwood. Okay. And we're looking into the Ballantyne at the minute as well.
Okay.
Nice to get the presentation up and see the names and phone numbers. Is it possible to give us a specific example of how you help someone and
yes.
what you do?
I wanted to do that, but because it was a presentation, I didn't want to jump in. We've had several phone calls, several referrals, and a couple of the team came to me the other day. Being the lead connector, they come to me and just ask some advice of what they feel they should do next. So I used to be a previous Reach Out member. And so this lady that's come to them, she's on ESA, she's in what they call RAG, and she's wheelchair bound, and she feels socially isolated, suffering with a bit of anxiety, but quite confident really. And she wants to get involved in something outside, maybe in the evening, but doesn't know how to get there, get back, and would like someone to attend with her. So they found like a rock in the area, and we've been given permission to attend outside of work.
Yeah.
So meet the individual there. So the girls are going to look into Merseylink to get her to get picked up from home, taken straight to the venue, and do that a couple of times to assist her to go along. And then from there they'll work with her. It's all around the individual and what they want. On the situation. Mark's working with a gentleman currently who's got anxiety as well, but is a keen into photography, and so he wants something voluntary, but he wants it around photography. So we work with a group called Periscope, and they've worked with us before with individuals on ESO on our pilot before this, and so he's going to be engaging with him soon to shadow him, and that will help him hopefully to go back into the workplace in the long run. So those are the sorts of things. Is there anything specific you're looking for?
And to find these people, that's where you do your door knocking, yeah?
Door knocking, and yeah, predominantly door knocking, and then referrals through Job Centre Plus as well, and any other organisation that wants to refer in.
And so how does someone become a volunteer? If someone wanted to volunteer to work with you, they just contact one of these numbers, yeah?
It just gives a call.
The reason we put the photographs on the leaflets as well is that we wanted to break down that barrier. So we're conscious there is quite a lot of door locking at the moment. So we put the team's photographs on, so as to say, we are your connectors for your area. We put the leaflet through and then we knock 2 days later. So we hope, because it's orange, you won't get in the mix of all the leaflets that go through over these doors, so it breaks down a bit of a barrier. And we don't just also knock once, we will go back continuously.
Plus, it, most of the leaflets are boy-girl,
yeah.
But if an individual is uncomfortable with a male or uncomfortable with a female, we'll switch teams around, whatever is suited to that individual.
So they go knocking on doors as teams, not on their own?
It goes pairs.
As pairs.
Yeah. We have one team who's in a three because it's a shared partnership. But yeah, they go in pairs, never lone working.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
One of the things that interests me is that we're all about, maybe we're all about it now, I shouldn't say everybody is, but to encourage us to be better neighbours.
Yes.
And yeah. Is that something that you...
I'll give you an example. We went on a door knock the other day, and I knocked at number one. I was in Rock Ferry. I knocked at number one, and I was asking some questions of the lady. Do you feel anyone... Have you got any concerns about anyone in your area? Do they feel isolated? And she mentioned number 9. And in the meantime, she mentioned something about herself, so went through some forms with her and everything. I went to number 7, asked the same questions, and she mentioned number 9. So it highlighted number 9 as socially isolated in their mind, because she'd had a house fire, she had a son who had issues with alcoholism, and they weren't being criticised of them, there was more of a concern. So what we've done with that is we've made it as a referral to Age UK, and because she's of that age really for support, and then
now going to address that. So that's the sorts of things we come across.
I was just going to say, I think, yeah, kind of assertive outreach approach, kind of going out, getting out on the community door knocking is key. And I really like the idea that you kind of, if people need that support to go somewhere, that you do that, because that's often that little nudge at people that people need, isn't it, to get started, really. I just had a couple of questions. First thing was, have you got any exclusion criteria? I know you've said in terms of kind of who your focus group is, but is there any exclusion criteria? And also, how would we refer people to you?
We don't really have any exclusion, we would never exclude people. We obviously have our priority group to take some, and that's what we're funded under, but we would never not support anybody, so if we ask that, it's no.
Yeah.
And somebody can be referred straight in through the Connect Us email or through the website as well. Actually, the web page, one web page is there, there'll be a referral form on there.
The thing is, we've never shut down, because the years that a lot of us community connectors have been involved within the community anyway, in other roles, drugs, alcohol, mental health, youth, and what have you, we've all got those skills and expertise to know where to signpost people anyway.
Yeah.
So pretty much, we're pretty much covered.
Yeah. Okay.
I think all the teams local, all the people in the team.
Yeah, that's
you know, when you gather all the data, so you know that you've done the doorknock, you've got the person, you're going to go and work with them now and stay with them. Where does that data go to then?
It goes to us and we formulate it.
Does it go to all the people that might need them, like adult social services, for example?
It goes to public health.
So
we've done it at ward level now rather than generic as in just the whole project, because we felt that there will be emerging issues coming out of communities as we door knock and as we engage, and it was really important to feed that back. So we'll be able to do that within our reporting as well.
Okay, fantastic. Anyone else? You're all okay? And can I thank you very much indeed for the very good report there? Thank you very much indeed for coming on. Okay. Can we move on then to item 5, which is the Community Centre and People's Real Estate, and I'll ask George, Emma and Kath to come forward.
Good morning, Chair.
Good morning.
Good morning. Waiting for them to see which one starts talking first. It's one thing I know she's going to walk about.
Okay,
on with the residents and how's it working out for you? Because you gave them a thanks, I presume.
Don't get me wrong, there is still that suspicion of the way the transfer was done. But, you know, let's go really, we've got to work with people. And all the same with LHT have actually demonstrated a willingness to work with them and we're working with them. And yeah, we do have little problems where we have to try and be peacemakers, but, you know, we get over it. And at the end of the day, it's we do this work for the residents of Beechwood, you know, not because we've got personality problems.
So the Scousers haven't turned you over then?
Okay, anybody else? George? Kath? Emma? Anything else? Kath? Would you speak? That's very good, George. Jobs like that, which will cost many thousands
two rural after school clubs and they get a hot meal. And we involve the children in the cooking of the hot meal. And our aim is that at the end of our first year, every child that attends the after school club will like at least one vegetable. We haven't managed it yet. There's one of our lovely planters within the room. Some of the funding that we've got, because you know, George, that is an eternal quest, isn't it,
yes,
to stay sustainable. We are funded through a variety of sources. John Walls gave us funding to set up
take shape now